Inequalities in two triangles. Our objective is to apply inequalities in two triangles. Who uses this? Designers of this circular swing ride can use the angle of the swings to determine how high the chairs will be at full speed. Inequalities in two triangles. Our objective is to apply inequalities in two triangles. Who uses this? Designers of this circular swing ride can use the angle of the swings to determine how high the chairs will be at full speed. Let's look at inequalities in two triangles. The hinge theorem. If two sides of one triangle are congruent to two sides of another triangle, and the included angles are not congruent, then the longer third side is across from the larger included angle. So if you're looking, if angle A is larger than angle D, then the distance from BC is going to be larger than the distance from E to F. The converse of the hinge theorem is just that theorem backwards. So if GH is larger, then angle J is going to be the larger angle. Let's use the hinge theorem and its converse. So we're going to compare the measure of angle PQS, so PQS, and the measure of angle RQS. So we're looking at which one is bigger, this angle here or this angle here. Alright, well, since 7 is the same length, or PQ is the same length as RQ, and QS is the same length as QS, we now can look at our third side. So, which side is larger? Well, PS is the larger side, so therefore the measure of angle PQS is going to be larger. Let's try another example. So let's compare KL and MN. So KL and MN. Which one is larger? Well, we have LM is the same length as KN, and then they share side LN, so that's the same length. So now when we're looking at the third side, we can determine which one is larger. So angle MLN has the larger angle, so therefore MN is larger than KL. Let's look at trying to find the range of values for Z in this case. All right, so we have sides, so let's compare our side lengths. We know that we have UV is congruent to WV, and we know that TV is congruent to TV. And then when we look, we notice that TU is smaller than TW, which means that angle UVT is going to be smaller than angle WVT. So therefore, we'll have 6Z minus 3 has to be less than 45. And when we solve for Z, we end up with 8. A lot of people will stop here, but you're missing a piece. The important piece here is that you have to make sure that you also don't include negative numbers. Like if Z has to be less than 8, well, negative 700 is less than 8. But if you put in negative 700, you might end up with a value for Z that makes this angle not a possible angle. So the angle has to be greater than 0, not Z. the angle has to be greater than 0, so set the measure of the angle greater than 0. So 6z minus 3 needs to be greater than 0. All right, so add 3 to both sides and divide by 6. So z has to be larger than 0.5. So then if we combine our two inequalities, you'll have your full range of values for z. So we have 0.5. z has to be larger than 0.5, but smaller than 8. Let's try comparing angle measures. So the measure of angle EGH, so we have EGH, so it's this angle here, and the measure of angle EGF, so this angle over here. Alright, well, when we look at it, we notice that we have FG and HG, they're the same length. They both share EG, so we know that's the same length. So therefore, we can now look at our third side. So we have 9 and 10. So across from the largest side is the larger angle. So the measure of angle EGF is going to be greater than the measure of angle EGH. Let's try another example. BC and AB. So we're looking at this side and this slide here. Alright, well, we have two sides that are the same length. We have AD is congruent to CD, and we know BD is congruent to BD for the reflexive property. So now we're looking at our angle measures. So across from our larger angle is our larger side. The larger angle is 65, so therefore BC is our larger side. Let's look at an entertainment application. The angle of the swings in a circular swing ride changes with the speed of the ride. The diagram shows the possible, the diagram shows the position of the swing at two different speeds. Which rider is farther from the base of the swing tower? Well, the slower one is to the left and the faster one is to the right. So as the speed increases, the rider goes farther away. So the angle formed by the swing in position A is smaller than the angle formed by the swing in position B. Let's look at a proof. Proving triangle relationships. So you're given that KL is congruent to NL, and we need to prove that KM is greater than NM. So let's start with our given. So we have KL is congruent to NL, and we know that because they gave it to us. And now let's use the reflexive property. So for the reflexive property, we can notice that LM is congruent to LM. Now this is when it starts to get a little bit trickier. So we have the measure of angle KLM equals, so the measure of angle, I'll highlight that in here, we've got the measure of angle KLM equals the measure of angle NLM plus the measure of angle KLN. So once you add those two together, you get this total one here. Well, you know that because of the angle addition postulate. So now when we start comparing, we have the measure of angle KLM. KLM is going to be greater than the measure of angle NLM because that's only a piece of your bigger angle. And because of that, it's going to force KL or KM to be larger than NM by the hinge theorem. And that concludes our lesson on inequalities in two triangles.